Welcome to the History of Ghosts and Legends. Tonight we're at one of the most haunted Sems in Merseyside, St James's, Liverpool. I'm just going to be giving you a little tour of what's going on. This is the main gate where you go in, down to the graveyard. What it was here, before it was a graveyard, it was actually a stone quarry. An actual person came along, John Foster, and he designed it into a cemetery in the end. So what we're going to do now is we're going to take you down into the Sem. Going down here on your left and right, you'll see gravestones. In the 1930s, these got taken up, and the Sem was supposed to be refurbished. The council was given the money to refurbish the Sem, and it never come through, so the gravestones never went back down again. So what happens is, when you go down the tunnel here, you will see the gravestones either side of the tunnel. And this is the only way out of the actual quarry that was built by the stonemasons. The only way out is this tunnel. It's cut through. Now on OS maps, the tunnel says it's a natural arch. When you go through, you'll see all the chisel marks on the walls. And here's the gravestones I was telling you about. They line the tunnel, right down the tunnel. In this tunnel, there's been a lot of things seen in here, especially a grey lady as well, late at night. It's been captured in here. Also, there's a video online as well of an apparition coming up the floor here in the middle of the tunnel. Now on your left hand side here is Mount Zion. It's also the part of the cemetery from years ago. And now this part of the Sem here, it's where the stonemasons used to go in and out, where there's tunnels in the walls. We'll get to that part in a minute and tell you about the history down there. It was also called St James's Mount, but it got the name Mount Zion later on. I'll tell you why when we get down there. Right, we're venturing into the tunnel now. This tunnel, if you ever come down here, you will get a lot of activity in this. So that if you use a camera or a phone, you'll always pick something up through this tunnel. And again, on the sides, you have the gravestones going down either side of the tunnel. When we get down this tunnel, on the left hand side is the first person to be buried in the cemetery. Stone here. This is the first person that was buried in the cemetery, the very first interment. Right, we're going on round the corner now. This is called Mount Zion. This part of the cemetery here, Mount Zion, was actually used to practice witchcraft in here. It was called the Wiccans at the time, and there was an Ed witch called Jenna Green, which is supposed to be buried over in the wall over here on the left hand side of the cemetery. Now when you walk through here, if we can see it now and pick it up on the camera, there's etchings on the walls of like the witchcraft time. When you see the level of the stone when it came down, when they cut the rock, this is an old fountain here as well, from years ago. Now they used to have a lady down here and they used to call her the bird lady. This is where all the birds used to get fed the water, and they had all like aviaries around this part of the cemetery. This part of the Sem, if you look in the Liverpool Echo and the Daily Mirror and that, this one over here, one of our members picked up the soldier on this part, over on the left-hand side here by this big tree. This is where the apparition of the Prince Rupert soldier was. Going into here, we're coming up to the tunnels now. On the very far side of the cemetery is the hearse tunnel, where they used to take the hearse in and out. And it used to be used by the people when they quarried in here for the stone. They used to take the stone out on carts and bring it in. It comes out on Rodney Street, the bottom of Hope Street somewhere, the other end of the tunnel, which has never been found. This tunnel here was one of the earliest tunnels, and it actually got dug through, and with the weight of the cathedral and all that on it, it collapsed inside, so it had to be blocked. But moving on, if you go up towards this one here, this is the main tunnel, like I said before, where they used to take the stone through, and they used to use it for the hearse. Now looking on this wall here, this is where all the etchings and the drawings are and that. If you look at the carvings on the wall, these carvings on the wall and the names are the stonemasons from years ago. Over on the left hand side here, you see loads of stones as you go down. This is the orphans' graves, all the ones from the Blue Coat Chambers. All the orphans, the kids died them days of cholera and all kinds of diseases like that. But what we'll do is we'll take you down here, and the next story will be Little Grace over on the left hand side. But as we're walking down, I'll show you this tree down here. So you can see here in the middle, we had a group of people one night, and we brought out a few spirit boards, and to each spirit board we had three people. The spirit board come up here with three people on it, saying that they were buried in an unmarked grave, and when they were asked what it was, it come up that they were all murderers that was actually there. And then we got a fourth person coming up, and we asked him why he came up late, and he turned around and said he'd been buried there with them, and he'd been hung for stealing a loaf of bread. This is the only running spring in Merseyside. It used to be used by doctors in Rodney Street years ago, this, for curing ailments, bad eyes, bad stomachs, and also artery, your heart, anything to do with your heart, any bad circulation and stuff like that. Now there's a story to this spring. If you look down London Road, in between where you go into Liverpool One, there's a gold cross on the floor. There used to be a church there, and when the church got knocked down, you had to move the bodies from there into this cemetery here. Well, this spring runs through Church Street, and they're actually petrified the bodies through all these sediments and the chemicals in the water. There was one body called the Captain James Gerwin, which his face, he was all shiny. His coffin was lined with lead, and the sediments out of the water here caused him to go petrified, all stiff in the coffin when he was found. And as I said, this is the only running spring in Merseyside that can be drunk for all different ailments. tell me when you're thinking.
Yeah.
This is the tomb of William Hutchinson. The actual plinth on there used to have a statue on there. It was removed, and it was actually put up the south end of Liverpool. And in the riots, in the toxic riots, it got smashed up because they thought it was a slave trader. It's also been repaired now, and it's down the road here in one of the new builds. And it stands there, the statue, the repaired one. It was never brought back here. But the actual place where you come in, the oratory, up on the front, it's got a lot of statues up there from Liverpool from years ago. If you look back on my site, we have got a video up there, what we did in there a couple of months ago. So any information you want, just let me know and I'll put the video back up for you.
I think I switched it off as you did it.
Let me go that bit. Okay, we've come to the end of our tour now. If you want to ever come on one of my events, there's a lot more interesting stories for you to see. And at the end of this video, we'll have all the links where you can go to, the YouTube channel, and also the link of our site on Facebook. Thanks very much for looking in. Hope to see you all soon. Good night.